Hello friends, welcome to my channel conqueryourclutter.com. Hope you are all doing great. Today's video is going to be women's wardrobe organization. Now it consists of two parts. The first part is going to be the day-to-day wear. It consists of my salwars, jeans, kurtis, the home-worn clothes like nighties, home-worn salwars, makeup and other accessories. The part 2 of this wardrobe consists of heavy worn saris, salwars, my formals and other accessories related to them. My previous video was about the organizers hall. To be very frank with you, all of the organizers work very well except for one, which I would like to say is this one. It really did not work out for me. I thought I will organize all my long chains and other stuff in this one because I do not have much scarves or dupattas. Dupattas I have a separate plan that you can see it in my video. But this organizer did not work well because all my chains were very long and heavy and they kind of tilted to one side when I put it in the bottle. So I'm going to give this to my husband or my brother uses styles and other things for his wardrobe. Now let's get on to the video.
Hello friends, welcome to part 1 of my wardrobe organization, that is my day-to-day wear storage. This is the before footage. As you can see, this is a hot mess. I have created a structure and purchased all my organizers accordingly. I will link my organizers haul below if you want to take a look. So without further ado, let's get back to organization, shall we? I have kept all my crafting materials on the topmost shelf. I use this less frequently and I have to save these from my daughter's reach. So I found this top shelf to be ideal. Next comes the bottom wear section. I have folded all my pants, skirts and palazzos in KonMari method of folding and organized it in a filing system. I cannot tell you how happy I am after adopting to this method of folding and filing. This helps me to see all that I have at a single glance. You should all try this method to understand why I am so happy about it. This is my innerwear or lingerie section. I wanted all my garments to breathe, so I have used only baskets to organize them instead of the lingerie organizer. I have used the hanger section to hang all my salwars, chudidars and dupattas. These dented hangers came in handy while hanging the dupattas along with the salwars. The dent in the hanger helped the dupatta to stay in place instead of slipping around. I have organized my common dupattas in this hanger. I have used a cloth spin to hold them in place. This way they are not everywhere in my wardrobe and looks very neat. I have double folded all my clothes on the hanger section. By doing this, I can utilize the lower part to organize my accessories and makeup. This is my bangles collection. The green basket is for donation. The other two boxes are Amazon boxes which are decorated with some leftover blouse materials and gift wrapping paper. This is my earrings collection. The bigger box is my day-to-day collection. The smaller one has deeper compartments. It is perfect for storing my ethnic jewelry. I am using this vertical organizer from Home Center to display my lipsticks, perfumes and nail polishes. It looks so perfect and I am glad I found it. I will try and leave a link in the description box below for your reference. So this is how all of them look in my wardrobe. These are the items which I used almost daily. Now I know where everything is and saves a ton of time while getting ready in the morning. I have used this drawer to organize my skincare, makeup, contact lens, bindis, coolers and the extra pouch to pack my makeup whenever I travel. I have sorted everything according to their category using these acrylic organizers. The shelf below the skincare drawer can fit in 6 baskets. I have organized my household clothes like nighties, salwars, track pants and t-shirt in 3 baskets. The other 3 baskets I have used to organize my kurtis, western top and casual shirts. Again, I have used the KonMari method of holding and filing. This creates a look of neatness and you know where everything is at a single glance. I also avoid impulsive buying due to the lack of space in these baskets. Pretty cool, right? The last shelf in my wardrobe is used to storing my handbags, clutches and bathing towels. I mostly have cotton handbags. They are easy to wash and saves a ton of space if you roll them like the way I have done here. So this is it. Part 1 of my day-to-day wear organization. I was really overwhelmed on seeing my messy wardrobe. But if you tackle it with patience, proper structure and planning, we can achieve a clean, neat, clutter-free wardrobe. This wardrobe is not only looking beautiful, clutter-free, but also functional. Now I get ready for work without having to rummage through my pile of clothes for essential things. I'm going to tackle my occasional clothes like silk sarees, heavy work sarees, formals, etc. in part 2 of my wardrobe organization. Subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to be notified on my next video. Until then, happy conquering your clutter. This is Sangeeta signing off from conqueryourclutter.com. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Hope you all enjoyed watching this video. I have a small request to make. Kindly subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Also, please like, subscribe and share my videos. It helps me a lot. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Have a great day.